Good afternoon, YouTube. I wanted to show you the last punch list items that I got finished off on the water heater installs. I got all the hot water pipes insulated up to the point where they go through the wall there. I've even got the new hot water pipe for the utility sink insulated and along the flex hose there. And then if we zoom in a little bit, see I have a bonding wire that I have hooking the gas pipe. This is the hot water pipe, and then I run off to the right over that way, and I'm going to hook up the cold water pipe. So I have to clean up some old water softener plumbing that was off to the side. There's a couple of valves that don't work, and just want to clean up that piping, and then I'll hook up the last bonding clamp to the cold water piping over to the right, and I'll show you that on a separate video. I need to clean out the area there and shut off the water to the house. This is a new requirement, relatively new, and I guess the idea is they're wanting the gas pipe and the water piping all bonded together and tied to ground, and that's partly because the new trend is going towards plastic water and gas piping coming into houses. If you had plastic pipe coming into the house, either the gas and or the water piping may not be grounded. So the idea is you want to tie all those pipes together and tie them into ground so that at some point, maybe in the future, maybe your water pipe coming into the house springs a leak and the city comes out, digs it up and replaces that with a plastic pipe, you would then lose your ground connections. And I think they're starting to require that in some areas, even on tank type water heaters. So the last item here, I replaced the receptacle there with a GFCI outlet. And then you have the grounding jumper bonding all the pipes to ground, and then on top of that you have a GFCI or RCD type of outlet or circuit. The main issue is this water heater is plugged into the grid right there. It's got live mains power inside. There's fans and blowers and power supply and circuit boards and whatnot, and it's hooked to all of the metal piping that's in your house. So if there were an electrical fault inside this unit, you could cause your water pipes in your house to become live, and then, you know, you go and touch the cold and the hot water and you could have a problem. So that's why I guess they're so concerned about having everything grounded. So then the last thing I did, just to kind of clean up the look of the whole thing, is I painted the OSB that I put on the wall to mount the heater to, and then I added a little decorative trim paint around the outside just to kind of make it look a little nicer. So I still have some painting to do on the wall here. That's some of the patching that was done a long time ago around the gas piping. They must have had some problem there. But then let me show you what I'm going to do with that in the future. Yeah, anyway, I still need to get in here behind the clothes washer because I need to get to the drain pipe there and add a T so I can come over here to where I'm going to mount the utility sink, which I have right down here just mocked up. Then I think what I'm going to do is I'll put a shelf about like this in here and cover up most of this piping. You know, I'll have the shelf roughly right about there, and, you know, I'll put some cutouts here to let the shelf sit up against the wall, and then I'll drop down off of the front to the level of the sink, and that way I can kind of attach the sink out at this level. And because I want to have the sink pulled out from the wall a ways, so I want to be flush here with the clothes washer and the dryer. So I'll build the shelf out from the wall, and that'll hide most of this patch job, and it'll also cover up all the drywall holes and whatnot that are down below there. So I'll show you the sink install when I get going a little bit. I got to build that shelf unit first and get that all set up. And what I'll show you, I'll do a separate video, and I want to discuss some of the reasons I picked this particular heater. Just share some of the information I learned about tankless water heaters that I didn't find in any other sources. So stay tuned for that video, and if you have any other questions about the basic install, post up in the comments section down below there, and I'll put any follow-up videos over here on the left side. You can check those out. And as always, thanks for watching.